بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد الصادق الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله الطاهرين الطيبين وعلى أصحابه أجمعين وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى ذريته إلى يوم الدين سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا اللهم علما وعملا متقبلا آمين يا رب العالمين حدثنا الشيخ العلامة الداعية المربي السيد محمد أبو الهدى ابن السيد إبراهيم ابن السيد إسماعيل اليعقوبي الدمشقي الحسيني حفظه الله تعالى ونفعنا به آمين في منزله المبارك بمنطقة قرى الأسد الصبورة في ريف دمشق الشام سنة 1427 الموافق لعام 2006 بكتاب رسالة المسترشدين للإمام الحارث بن أسد المحاسبي رحمه الله تعالى ونفعنا به آمين قال أبو عبد الله الحارث بن أسد المحاسبي رحمه الله تعالى أو رحمة الله عليه وسنبدأ بقراءة الشيخ اليعقوبي لهذا المتن كما سجلها بعض الموفقين عند أناء الدرس كأن منع الصوت أن يخرج من أجل هذا البث المباشر لا بأس قال أبو عبد الله الحارث بن أسد المحاسبي رحمة الله عليه الحمد لله الأول القديم الواحد الجليل الذي ليس له شبيه ولا نظير أحمده حمدا يوافي نعمه ويبلغ مدى نعمائه Glory to Allah, the first, the one without beginning, the one to whom there is no second, the majestic, who has nothing resembling him and no equivalent or counterpart. I glorify him with a glorifying that meets his immense favors and reaches the extent of his graces. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة عالم بربوبيته عارف بوحدانيته. And I bear witness that there is no God but Allah alone without partner, with the witnessing of a someone who is fully knowing of his lordship and nurtureship and fully cognizant of his oneness. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم اصطفاه لوحيه وختم به أنبياءه he chose and selected him for his revelation and sealed with him his prophets وجعله حجة على جميع خلقه and made him a final proof over all of his creatures ليهلك من هلك عن بينة ويحيى من حي عن بينة وإن الله لسميع عليم so that whoever perishes shall perish based on a clear demonstration and whoever lives shall live based on a clear demonstration and truly Allah is all hearing and all knowing أما بعد فاعلم أن الله عز وجل اجتبى من عباده المؤمنين ذوي الألباب العالمين به وبأمره To proceed, know that Allah Most High has chosen of His servants the believers who have hearts and who know full well of Him and of His command. فوصفهم بالوفاء والأخلاق الفاضلة والخوف والخشية. And so He described him as truthful or loyal and as possessing high character and fear and fear of him. فقال عز وعلا إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب الذين يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق والذين يصلون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل ويخشون ربهم ويخافون سوء الحساب. And he said in his glorious book, only those who have hearts do remember, and those who are faithful to the covenant of Allah and do not breach that pact, and those who keep ties with whatever Allah ordered them to, and fear their Lord and fear a bad reckoning. فَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِيمَانِ وَوَصَلَ التَّصْدِيقُ إِلَى قَلْبِهِ وَرَغِبَ فِي الْوَسِيلَةِ إِلَيْهِ لَزِمَ مِنْهَاجَ ذَوِي الْأَلْبَابِ. So whoever Allah expanded their chest with faith and confirmation reached their hearts and they are yearning for a means of access to Him, they keep steadfast or keep fast to the path of the possessors of hearts. برعاية حدود الشريعة من كتاب الله تعالى وسنة نبيه عليه الصلاة والسلام وما اجتمع عليه المهتدون من الأئمة. By observing the boundaries of the sacred law out of the book of Allah Most High, the Quran, and the sunnah of his prophet, upon him blessings and peace, and all that the well-guided ones of the leaders in religion, the imams, have concurred upon. So these are the three foundations of the religions, Quran, Sunnah, and Ijma, consensus. قال وهذا هو الصراط المستقيم الذي دعا إليه عباده فقال جل وعزة. This is the straight path to which he called his servants, and he said وأن هذه صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون. And that this is my path, straight, so follow it and do not follow the various paths that will separate you or disseminate you or disperse you from away from his path. That is what he has commanded you with. Perhaps you will beware of him. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بسنة وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين من بعد عضوا عليها بالنواجز. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you must follow my path and the path of the well-guided caliphs after me. Bite upon it with your molars. وعلم أن فريضة كتاب الله العمل بحكمه من الأمر والنهي. والخوف من وعيده والرجاء لوعده والإيمان بمتشابهه والاعتبار بقصصه وأمثاله. Know that the absolute categorical command of the Book of Allah is the putting into practice of its rulings based on commands and prohibition, and الأولى الخوف والخوف العمل والخوف من وعيده والرجاء لوعده والإيمان بمتشابه والاعتبار بقصصه وأمثاله. هذا كله معطوف على العمل، ليس كذلك؟ نعم. And putting into practice its rulings of commands and prohibitions, fearing its threats and hoping for its rewards, and believing in its obscure or ambiguous passages, and taking to heart its stories and its proverbs or its allegories. قال فإذا أتيت بذلك فقد خرجت من ظلمات الجهل إلى نور العلم. If you do that, you have come out of the darknesses of ignorance to the light of knowledge. ومن عذاب الشك إلى روح اليقين. And out of the punishment of doubt to the ila rawh al-yaqin, to the restfulness of Allah jalla dhikruh, Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Allah said, Most High, Allah is the patron and protector and friend of those who believe. He brings them out of the darknesses into the light. وَإِنَّمَا يُمَيِّزُ ذَلِكَ وَيَرْغَبُ فِيهِ أَهْلُ الْعَقْلِ وَالْفَهْمِ عَنِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا فِي أَحْكَامِ الظَّاهِرِ وَتَنَزَّهُ عَنِ الشُّبُهَاتِ. And only those who distinguish that are those who are truly yearning for Allah among the people endowed with reason. أهل العقل وهذا أول ذكر للعقل وسيذكره كثيرا. He says everything is based on a sound mind, a faith-informed mind. So correct faith has to recognize the place of mind and reason, because Allah is always calling upon us to use our minds and our reason in the Holy Quran. So the people of minds and understanding of what Allah says to them, anillah, who put into practice the external rulings and keep clear of ambiguities and of the gray zones. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الحلال بين والحرام بين وبين ذلك أمور مشتبهات. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what is lawful is very clear, what is unlawful is very clear, and between that and that there are some unclear matters. تركها خير من أخذها. To leave these aside is better than to take them. فافحص عن النية واعرف الإرادة فإن المجازاة بالنية. So examine well your intention and know your will, for the requital is based or is through intention. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, actions count only according to intentions, and every person shall only have what they intended. وَلْزَمْ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ الْمُسْلِمَ مَنْ سَلِمَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَيَدِهِ وَالْمُؤْمِنَ مَنْ آمِنَ النَّاسُ بَوَائِقَهِ. And keep fast to the fear of Allah or awareness of Allah, for truly the Muslim is defined as the one from whose tongue and whose hand other Muslims are safe, and the believer, or the one who surrenders, and the believer is the one from whose harm people are safe. See, so the believer is in a higher level than the Muslim, and here the second half mentions the people as opposed to the Muslims at large as the beneficiaries of his keeping his own harm in check. قال أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه اتق الله بطاعته وأطع الله بتقواه وكف يدك عن دماء المسلمين وبطنك عن أموالهم ولسانك عن أعراضهم وحاسب نفسك في كل خطرة. أبو بكر الصديق, the first caliph and the closest and most intimate friend of the Holy Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, أبو بكر said, may Allah be well pleased with him, fear Allah through obeying him, and obey Allah by fearing him, and or by bewaring of him, and keep your hand away from the blood of Muslims, and keep your belly away from their property, and your tongue away from their honor, and take account of yourself in every passing thought. وراقب الله في كل نفس. And observe Allah in every breath you take. قال عمر رضي الله عنه. And Umar, the second caliph and second closest confidant of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم among his caliphs, رضي الله عنه, said, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا وزنوها قبل أن توزنوا وتزينوا للعرض الأكبر يوم لا تخفى منكم خافية. Take account of yourselves before you are reckoned, and weigh them before you are weighed, and adorn yourselves for the great review, meaning the day of judgment, on the day that no small matter or no hidden matter of yours shall be remain hidden anymore. وَخَفِ اللَّهَ فِي دِينِكَ وَارْجُهُ فِي جَمِيعِ أُمُورِكَ وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ. Fear Allah concerning your religion and hope for Him in all of your issues and concerns, and keep steadfast even whenever you face difficulties. قال علي رضي الله عنه. Ali, the third closest of the Khulafa Rashidin to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, together with Uthman ibn Affan, may Allah be well pleased with him, said, so Ali said, لا تخف إلا ذنبك ولا ترجو إلا ربك ولا تستحي الذي لا يعلم أن يسأل حتى يعلم. ولا يستحي عفواً ولا يستحي الذي لا يعلم أن يسأل حتى يعلم ولا يستحي من يسأل عما لا يعلم أن يقول لا أعلم. He said, do not fear except your own sin. Do not hope except from your Lord. Do not be ashamed, or let he not be ashamed, the one who does not know, to ask until he gets to know. And whoever does not know and who is being asked, let them not be ashamed to say, I do not know. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الصَّبْرَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الرَّأْسِ مِنَ الْجَسَدِ. Know that fortitude or patience is in relation to faith, as the head is in relation to the body. فَإِذَا قُطِعَ الرَّأْسُ ذَهَبَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. When the head is cut off, the whole body dies. فَإِذَا سَمِعْتَ كَلِمَةً. In other words, when there is no patience, there is no usefulness to your religion. قال فإذا سمعت كلمة تغضبك في عرضك فاعف واصفح فإن ذلك من عزم الأمور. So when you, if you hear a word that makes you angry, that touches your honor, look the other way, forgive and forbear, for truly that is, that shows firm resolve. قال عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه من خاف الله لم يشف غيظه ومن اتقاه لم يصنع ما يريد ولولا يوم القيامة لكان غير ما ترعون. عمر رضي الله عنه ابن الخطاب said, be Allah be well pleased with him, whoever fears Allah does not vent his anger, and whoever fears him does not do just anything he wishes, and were it not for the day of resurrection, you would see other than that. وَرَاعِ هَمَّكْ وَاشْتَغِلْ بِإِصْلَاحِ نَفْسِكَ عَنْ عَيْبِ غَيْرِكَ. And take care of your concern and busy yourself by reforming your own soul rather than busying yourself with other people's faults. فَإِنَّهُ كَانَ يُقَالُ كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ عَيْبًا أَنْ يَسْتَبِينَ لَهُ مِنَ النَّاسِ مَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ مِنْ نَفْسِهِ. It used to be said, or they used to say, the sages of old, it is enough of a blemish for a person that they are aware, or that they are clearly aware about other people what they are not even aware of concerning their own soul. And they are aware of other people's faults, but they are unaware of their own faults. This is enough sin for us to be in that situation. أَوْ يَمْقُتَ النَّاسَ فِي مَا يَأْتِي مِثْلَهُ. Or that he should hate and have rancor against people over what he himself commits of bad deeds. أَوْ يُؤْذِيَ جَلِيسَهُ. Or that he harm those who sit with him. Or أَوْ يَقُولَ فِي النَّاسِ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهُ. Or that he should say concerning people what is of no concern to him. واستعمل لله عقلك بترك التدبير واستعن بالله على صرف المقادير. This is something that Ibn Ata'illah also spoke about, and even wrote a whole book about that. use for the sake of Allah, use your mind by relinquishing your disposal of your own affairs, and use Allah for help, or rely on Allah for help over the disposal of, or in dealing with all that takes place, all that He has appointed for you, meaning of wealth, of health, of time, of leisure, of actions, of restfulness, or of activity, of sickness, and of life and death, and everything that touches you and that is around you. That is maqadir, the apportionment of Allah Most High. Trust in Allah and rest on Him, and do not try to control that. Qala Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ya ibn Adam, لا تفرح بالغنى ولا تقنط بالفقر ولا تحزن بالبلاء ولا تفرح بالرخاء. And this is one of the sub-themes, of the important sub-themes of this book. Trust in Allah and in goodness and in difficulty and in wealth and in poverty. O son of Adam, Ali said, may Allah be well pleased with him. O human being, do not be gleeful or happy with wealth, and do not despair in poverty, and do not be sad in trials, and do not be happy in ease. For truly, فَإِنَّ الذَّهَبَ يُجَرَّبُ بِالنَّارِ, gold is tested through fire, وَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ الصَّالِحَ يُجَرَّبُ بِالْبَلَاءِ, and the righteous servant is tested and tried through difficulties and trials. Now, this is actually a hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that wording. قال وإنك لا تنال ما تريد إلا بترك ما تشتهي. We will never be able to obtain what you want except by leaving and relinquishing what you are hankering after. ولن تبلغ ما تؤمل إلا بالصبر على ما تكره. And you will never be able to reach also what you hope to reach except by having patience and fortitude, by bearing with what you hate. وَبْذُلْ جُهْدَكَ لِرِعَايَةِ مَفْطُرِدَ عَلَيْكَ, and spend all your every effort to in observing what was made obligatory upon you of obligations. وَرْضَ بِمَا أَرَادَكَ اللَّهُ لَهُ, and be pleased with what Allah Most High wants for you. This is the most difficult thing, and this is the whole game. This is the whole religion. This is the whole goal, to be pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed for us. And there is this sentence in dua, such a dua in Dala'il Khairat, Allahumma afridni lima khalaqtani lahu. Oh Allah, single me out and help me to do just what you created me for. Oh, and this is what Allah wants from us, and it is to know Him, to love Him, and to worship Him. And it is not easy. It is easily said, but it's not easily done. So, قال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه ارضى بما قسم الله لك تكن من أغنى الناس واجتنب ما حرم الله عليك تكن من أورع الناس. Ibn Mas'ud, one of the major companions, said, may Allah be well pleased with him, be well pleased with what Allah Most High apportioned for you and divided up for you, and you will be among the wealthiest of people, richest of people, and avoid what Allah has made unlawful for you. You will be of the most God-fearing of people. وَأَدِّ مَا افْتَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ تَكُنْ مِنْ أَعْبَدِ النَّاسِ, and perform or accomplish what Allah made obligatory for you, you will be of the most worshipful of people. وَلَا تَشْكُ مَنْ هُوَ أَرْحَمُ بِكَ إِلَى مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمُكَ. This is a tremendous advice, huge advice. يعني هذا عظيم. لا تشكو, يعني لا تشتكي. تشتكي من؟ تشكو من؟ تشكو الله سبحانه وتعالى. إلى من؟ إلى الناس. نقول, oh, Allah has tested me with this. Oh, Allah has given me. Oh, this is happening to me. And, well, this is from whom? From Allah. As if you are accusing now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To whom? to those who have are completely powerless. Aside from Allah, they will never be able to help you at all. It is Allah who helps and who decides. And Allah who puts you in this difficulty. So do not accuse the one who is more merciful to you in the presence of, or accuse him, accuse Allah, to the one who has no mercy for you. All creation, they possess no mercy for you to give. Whatever mercy they express is all derivative from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all mercy is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ وَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ تَكُنْ مِنْ أَهْلِ خَاصَّتِهِ, and use and seek and ask Allah for help, you will be of his intimates. قَالَ عُبَادَةُ بْنُ الصَّامِتِ رضي الله عنه في وصيته لابنه, and this is another one of the major companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, عُبَادَةُ بْنُ الصَّامِتِ, the Yemeni, Allah be well pleased with him, in his last will and testament to his son, he said, يَا بُنَيَّ أَظْهِرِ الْيَأْسَ بِمَّا فِي أَيْدِ النَّاسِ فَإِنَّهُ الْغِنَى وَإِيَّاكَ وَالطَّمَعَ وَطَلَبَ الْحَاجَاتِ إِلَى النَّاسِ فَإِنَّهُ الْفَقْرُ. Oh my son, show and make full use of despair of what is in the hands of people, for that is true wealth. And beware of having any covetousness and or of having any petition before people or asking people for your needs, for truly that is poverty. Look, you see, this is the free man. Free men speak like that and think like that and act and believe like that. Allah make us of them, and not to be slaves of our lusts and of our fears and false hopes. Ameen. قَالَ وَإِذَا صَلَّيْتَ فَصَلِّ صَلَاةَ مُوَدِّعِينَ, and when you pray, pray the prayer of one who bids adieu, who says goodbye to this life and this world. In every prayer, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّكَ لَنْ تَجِدَ طَعْمَ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنَ بِالْقَدَرِ كُلِّهِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ, and know that you shall never find the taste of faith, the true taste of faith, until you really believe in the divine decree, the divine measurement, the divine apportionment. This is what they call predestination, but it is much more than that. It is not in the way that fatalists believe in, hasha wa kalla. It's not at all like that. Islam is the middle way, and there is no determinism in Islam, and there is no fatalism in Islam, and there is no creation of your own destiny in Islam. It is the middle way. It says, until you believe in qadar, all of it, until you believe in the divine decree, all of it, the good and the bad of it. In other words, the sweet and the bitter, is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكُنْ قَائِلًا بِالْحَقِّ عَامِلًا بِهِ يَزِدْكَ اللَّهُ نُورًا وَبَصِيرًا. Be one who speaks truth and who puts it into practice, Allah shall increase you in your light and in your spiritual insight. Al-Basira hiya basar al-qalb. Al-basar fil al-aynayn. So sight is basar and insight is basira. وَلَا تَكُنْ مِمَّنْ يَأْمُرُ بِهِ وَيَنْأَ عَنْهُ, and do not be one who commands it and yet keeps aloof from it. فَتَبُوءَ بِإِثْمِهِ وَتَتَعَرَّضَ لِمَقْتِ اللَّهِ, and you shall, if you do that, if you stay away from what you profess and what you command, and yet you do not put it into practice, you will be the one who commits it, and it will be counted against you, and you will be exposing yourself to the wrath of Allah. قال الله عز وجل كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. It is the most wrathful thing for Allah that you should profess what you do not do. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من وعظ ولم يتعظ وزجر ولم ينزجر ونهى ولم ينتهي فهو عند الله من الخائبين. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever admonishes and yet is not himself admonished, and exhorts or rebukes and is not himself rebuked and forbids and himself does not forbid himself, then that one is the biggest loser, or among the biggest losers in the divine presence. And the editor says, I could not find this hadith anywhere. لكن نقول نجاء معناه في حديث أشد الناس حسرة يوم القيامة رجل أمكنه طلب العلم فلم يطلبه ورجل علم علما فانتفع به في من سم فانتفع به من سمعه منه دونه. يعني the worst of people on the day of resurrection will be someone who the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is related to have said, this is in Ibn Asakir from Anas. So there is a basis that the worst of people in regretfulness on the day of resurrection will be a person who was able to ask for knowledge and pursue knowledge but did not do it, and a person who learned something and others benefited of that knowledge but he himself did not benefit from it. قال ولا تخالط إلا عاقلا تقيا. Do not frequent, يعني do not intermix with anyone except a person who is endowed with a mind and who is fearful of Allah, who bewares Allah. So عاقلاً, again you see, العاقل التقي. ولا تجالس إلا عالماً بصيراً. And do not sit with any except an insightful learned person. Not just any learned person, but an insightful learned person. And a person of hearts. And how many are the ulama who do not meet that requirement of true ilm. قال وقد سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أي جلسائنا خير فقال من ذكركم بالله رؤيته. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked, who among those we sit with are the best? And he said, whoever reminds you of Allah just by you seeing them. Now, قال وزاد في علمكم منطقه, and his speech increases you in your knowledge. وذكركم بالآخرة عمله, and his deeds remind you of the hereafter. Now, and this is narrated in the Musnad of Abd ibn Humayd, and also in the Musnad of Abu Ya'la, and anyway, it is well confirmed through many other narrations to that effect. And this is the gist of Sahl al-Tustari saying, sit with those whose sight speaks to you before their words. Those, when you see them, you already learn from them through their deeds and also through their appearance, because their appearance is supposed to also reflect the akhlaq muhammadiyya, yani the Muhammadan manners. قال وتواضع للحق واخضع له وأدم ذكر الله ثنا القربة. And humble yourself for truth and submit to it and do perpetual remembrance of Allah, you will obtain proximity to him. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جلساء الله يوم القيامة الخاضعون المتواضعون الخائفون الذاكرون الله كثيرا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, peace and blessings be upon him, those who sit with Allah on the day of the resurrection, or who shall sit with Allah on the day of resurrection without how and without physicality, because Allah is beyond that and beyond locality. So this is a metaphor of proximity to Allah and his good pleasure. Those who sit with Allah on the day of resurrection are those who submit, those who humble themselves, those who are fearful of him, those who remember Allah much. And its confirmation is in the holy verse, as-sadiqina was-sabirina wal-qanitina wal-munfiqina wal-mustaghfirina bil-ashar. قال وابذل النصيحة لله ولرسوله وللمؤمنين وشاور في أمرك الذين يخشون الله. And do your utmost in faithfully and transparently obeying Allah and His Messenger and counseling or dealing with the believers, and consult in your issues and your concerns those who fear Allah. قال الله عز وجل, and this is a hadith, وشاور في أمرك الذين يخشون يخشون الله. This is a hadith. The editor attributes it to Sayyidina Umar. However, it is actually a prophetic hadith. شاوروا في أموركم من يخشى الله أو نعم الذين يخشون الله. نعم. And this will come again later. You'll see that many of these passages and these ideas and these counsels will be repeated. The book is repetitive, but in a different manner every time. It is as if it is a collection of several aphorisms and hikam that were put together, perhaps by followers of the Shaykh, from different lessons that he gave around those themes, or that he himself put together, but without streamlining them into a single message, but rather a repetitive message through the musicality also of the passages, and you see, and the appropriateness of, because every new time that he mentions them, there is a new benefit that is added. That's why it bears repeating. Now, consult in your issues those who fear Allah. قال الله عز وجل إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. Allah said, Most High and Glorious, only those who know Allah truly fear Him among His servants. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الدين النصيحة. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Religion is true faithfulness, al-nasiha, sincere faithfulness, transparent faithfulness. And the continuation is faithfulness to Allah, to the Prophet, to his book, the Quran, to the leaders of the Muslims and to all Muslims. قَالَ وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَنْ نَصَحَكَ فَقَدْ أَحَبَّكَ. And know that whoever shows that transparent faithfulness to you, whoever gives you that nasiha, truly loves you. وَمَنْ دَاهَنَكَ فَقَدْ غَشَّكَ. And whoever adulates you has swindled you. يعني, to compliment you, flatter you. Whoever flatters you has cheated you. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَقْبَلْ نَصِيحَتَكَ فَلَيْسَ بِأَخٍ لَكَ. And whoever does not accept your transparent faithfulness is not a brother to you. قال عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه لا خير في قوم ليسوا بناصحين ولا خير في قوم لا يحبون الناصحين. Umar, may Allah be well pleased with him, said there is no goodness in a people that do not show nasiha, which is transparent, faithful advice, and there is no goodness in a people that do not accept or do not love nasiha. وآثر الصدق في كل موطن تغنم. And always prefer truthfulness in every context, you will reap every benefit. واعتزل الفضول تسلم. And keep or shun and keep away from superfluity, you will be safe. Now this superfluity, fudul, is a key term in Muhasibi, and he's going to mention it a lot. And اعتزل الفضول تسلم. هذا الدخول فيما لا يعني. نعم. يعني to stay away from what is of no concern to you. قال فإن الصدق يهدي إلى البر. For truly truthfulness leads to piety. والبر يهدي إلى رضا الله تعالى. And piety, righteousness, virtue leads to the good pleasure of Allah. والكذب يهدي إلى الفجور. And lying leads to open sinfulness. والفجور يورث سخط الله. And open sinfulness makes you inherit the wrath of Allah Most High.
وقال عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما
Abdullah ibn Abbas, the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, son of the uncle, and both of them were Muslims. May Allah be well pleased with them. Major Sahabis said, "لا تتكلم فيما لا يعنيك ودع كثيرا مما يعنيك ولا تمارس فيها ولا حليما واذكر أخاك بما تحب أن يذكرك به." And he said, "Do not speak about what is of no concern to you, and shun much of what is of concern to you." وهذا أصعب من الأول. نعم وهي هاتان قاعدتان مهملتان متروكتان قال الأستاذ سيدي محمد أبو الهدى اليعقوبي. And لا تتكلم فيما لا يعنيك فضلا عن الثانية التي هي أصعب دع كثيرا مما يعنيك. Do not speak of what concerns you and leave much of what does concern you. This is very much neglected, especially the first one, not to mention the second one, which is much more difficult to put into practice. And do not wrangle or dispute with a fool, nor with someone who is wise and patient. And you throw the riya wal نعم والجدال واذكر أخاك بما تحب أن يذكرك به and mention your brother only in terms that you like him to mention you. واعمل عمل رجل يعلم أنه مجازا بالإحسان مأخوذ بالإجرام. And do the deeds of a person who knows that they are going to be requited for excellence and taken to task for wrongdoing. وأدم شكر الله وقصر من أملك وزور القبور بهمك وتذكرك الموتى وجل في الحشر بقلبك. Always thank Allah and keep your hopes short and visit graves with all of your anxiety there. يعني see yourself already there. They will remind you of death and Rome. يعني in the eyes of your mind, Rome in the gathering of resurrection with your heart. جول يعني من ال يجولو جال يجولو جولة. وقال أبو ذر رضي الله عنه اعمل كأنك ترى وعد نفسك في الموتى واعلم أن الشر لا ينسى والخير لا يفنى. أبو ذر, another great Sahabi, also may Allah be well pleased with him, said, do as one who sees, meaning who sees Allah, تعبد الله كأنك ترى, and count yourself among the dead and know that evil is not forgotten, meaning it is recorded forever. And even in this world, people do not forget, you know, if you mistreat them. والخير لا يفنى, and goodness is never erased, and that is in the hereafter, even if people forget it in this world. وعلم أن قليلا يغنيك, and know that little suffices you. خير من كثير يطغيك, and that is better than much that يطغيك, that oppresses you and is treats you with tyranny, like our own possession enslave us, as we mentioned before, and become in control of us. وإياك ودعوة المظلوم ثم رم جهازك, and beware of the supplication of the person who was wronged by you. And this is from a hadith. The continuation of it is, فَإِنَّ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ حِجَابٍ, there is no barrier between it and Allah Most High, such a supplication. So in other words, do not wrong anyone, do not oppress anyone or thing. And then our teacher, Shaykh Muhammad Abu al-Huda al-Yaqubi, hafizahullah, said, جَهَازَكَ is more correct than جِهَازَكَ. It is more Quranic. So رمى جهازك من رمما, يعني consolidate your equipment, in other words, for the day of resurrection. So it's the same as take yourself to account. وَفْرُغْ مِنْ زَادِكَ, and clear yourself of your provision. Yani, what was your provision for the hereafter? Are you done with that? That's what he's saying. That should be your concern. Do not be done with that before anything else. قَالَ وَكُنْ وَصِيَّ نَفْسِكَ, and be your own bequeather, or the one who takes care of your own testament. What do you call that one? The executor of the testament. Yani, be your own executor of your own testament over your own soul. وَلَا تَجْعَلِ الرِّجَالَ أَوْصِيَاءَكَ. Do not make other people your executors, or the one who are in charge of you. وَعْقِلْ أَمْرَكَ. Clinch your affair. Tie it down. وَتَيَقَّظْ مِنْ سِنَتِكَ, and be fully aware, in the sense of wake up, and in the sense of beware also, of what? Of your fatigue and of your weakness. فَإِنَّكَ مَسْؤُولٌ عَنْ عُمُرِكَ, for truly you will be asked of your life, and of the years of your life, and of the days and moments of your life. Subhanallah. And just today, someone, may Allah reward them, sent me this saying of Al-Hasan al-Basri, Ya Ibn Adam, innama anta, O human being, you are but days, ayyam, innama anta ayyamun, you are just days. فَإِذَا ذَهَبَ يَوْمٌ فَذَهَبَ بَعْضٌ مِنْكَ. So every time, إِذَا ذَهَبَ ذَلِكَ, every time that one of your days elapses, part of you has left forever. And you are just a collection of days, and they are counted and numbered. And when the last of them comes, that's it. Nothing remains of you, subhanAllah. This is the same kind of wisdom. And all based on hadiths of the Holy Prophet ﷺ and the Holy Quran. قَالَ أَبُو أُمَامَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. Another great major sahabi, may Allah be well pleased with him, said, لَوْ عَقَلَ ابْنُ آدَمَ عَنْ رَبِّهِ كَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ مِنْ جِهَادِهِ. If only a human being understood his Lord's message, it would be much better for him than his all of his jihad put together. Yani, all of his efforts, whether in the path of Allah, in military action, or in against his own soul struggling, just to understand what his Lord wants of him, that is the best thing. So this is تفكر ساعة خير من عبادة سنة أو سبعين سنة أو ستين سنة. This was a leitmotiv of the Sahaba. Many Sahaba said this word. And it is also related as a prophetic hadith, that to think and reflect and meditate for 1 hour is better than to worship for a whole year or 60 years or 70 years. قَالَ وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَنْ جَعْلَ هَمَّهُ الْآخِرَةَ كَفَاهُ اللَّهُ أَمْرَ دُنْيَاهُ. Know that whoever makes his greatest concern the hereafter, Allah shall suffice them the issue of their worldly needs. كما ذكر في الحديث المروي, as was mentioned in the prophetic hadith, تفرغوا من هموم الدنيا ما استطعتم فإنه من كانت الدنيا أكبر همه أفشى الله عليه ضيعته وجعل فقره بين عينيه ومن كانت الآخرة أكبر همه جمع الله له أمره وجعل غناه في قلبه وما أقبل عبد بقلبه إلى الله عز وجل إلا جعل الله قلوب المؤمنين تنقاد إليه بالرحمة والمودة. هذا الشطر الأخير تنقاد إليه بالرحمة, هذا من حقيقة الجذبة, كيف يكتب الله المحبة لعبد من عباده في الأرض فينجذب الخلق إليه لهذا العبد من أولياء الله. هذا حقيقة الجذبة, هكذا سموها سماها المشايخ. Know that نعم, as mentioned in the hadith, be تفرغوا من هموم الدنيا, يعني finish your concerns of the concerns of this world as much as you can, for truly whoever this world is the greatest of their concern, Allah Most High shall expand for them their shall scatter their livelihood, and yani shall expand it and scatter it at the same time. In other words, it will be out of control. يعني يكون مهموما دائما. He will always be, all his time will be taken up by his agriculture, or his commerce and trade, or his job. And Allah shall make shall put his poverty in front of his eyes. In other words, he will always be seeing himself in need. أنا محتاج, أنا محروم, and deprived of something else. You will need something else. And this is the culture of modern economics and advertisement, to always make you feel in need of something that you don't yet have, always, all the time. وَمَنْ كَانَتِ And whoever has the hereafter as the greatest of their concerns, Allah Himself shall gather up their affair and shall put their wealth into their hearts. And no slave comes over with his heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah Almighty, except Allah shall make all the hearts of all believers be led to that one with mercy and love. And as we explained, this is called the reality of attraction, and it is a characteristic of the saints, or the pious, righteous, and holy servants of Allah Most High on earth, as confirmed in another hadith, that when Allah loves someone, Allah tells their angel, his angels, to write acceptance for that one on earth, and that one becomes beloved on earth. And no one can explain how it happens, but everyone can see that reality at work. The editor here said that this hadith is weak or very weak, but in fact it is narrated by Tirmidhi, who said it is Hassan, and also narrated by Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Ibn Majah and Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, and Al-Hakim in Al-Mustadrak, and Al-Bayhaqi in Az-Zuhd al-Kabir. The only one, the only part that is not in that, in those versions, is تَفَرَّهُ عَفْوًا مِنْ هُمُومِ الدُّنْيَا, the very first clause, that's all. But the rest is there, that's one. And two, the first clause is confirmed by other hadiths and sayings of the Sahaba also, especially a saying of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, تَفَرَّهُ أَوْ تَعَلَّمُوا قَبْلَ أَنْ تَسُودُوا or تُسَوَّدُوا. Learn before you are put in charge of other people's affairs. طيب. قال واحذر يا أخي المراء في القرآن, and beware, oh my brother, of wrangling over the Quran. And والجدال في الدين, and disputation in the religion. والكلام في التحديد, and of chit-chat or of talking about the limits, meaning the limits of Allah. Does Allah have limits? Of course, this kind of speech is inappropriate and rejected, and a characteristic of the people of evil innovations in their doctrines and anthropomorphism. They attribute a body to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكُنْ مِنَ الَّذِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِيهِمْ وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Be of those about whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whenever the ignorant ones address them, they just say peace. وَالْزَمِ الْأَدَبَ وَبَاعِدِ الْهَوَى وَالْغَضَبِ, and keep close to excellent manners, and keep far away and part ways with lusts and anger. وَأَعْمَلْ فِي أَسْبَابِ التَّيَقُّضِ وَالْمُرَاقَبَةُ غَايَةُ قَصْدِكَ. Practice the avenues of wakefulness. This is tasawwuf here. to be with those who will help you to be awake and to beware. As he said before, التيقظ, والمراقبة غاية قصدك. يعني make watchfulness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the utmost and the end, farthermost of your objective. إلهي أنت مقصودي ورضاك مطلوبي. This is a motto in tariqah. Oh Allah, you are my goal and my objective, and your good pleasure is what I ask. قال واتخذ الرفقة خدنا, and keep gentleness as your intimate. والتأني صاحبا, and pacing yourself and going slow as your friend and your companion. والسلامة كهفا, and safety as your cave. والفراغ غنيمة, leisure as your treasure. والدنيا مطية, this world as your mount. والآخرة منزلا, and the next world as your residence. All of this is from hadiths of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it's summed up. You see, this is not a book of teaching and learning and memorizing hadith, but rather this is a book for the uneducated masses of his time, and it is just summarizing the gist of the foundations of the religion and of the hadiths of verses and hadiths of guidance for the redress of character and good practice, with an appeal, of course, an emphasis on sincerity and simple living. وما قال قال الحسن رضي الله تعالى عنه إن الله تعالى لم يجعل للمؤمن راحة دون الجنة. الحسن البصري, one of the great tabi'in, successors coming after the time of the companions, may Allah be well pleased with him, said, truly Allah Most High did not grant the believer any rest before they reach paradise. And as the hadith states, that this world is the prison of the believer, and it is the paradise of the unbeliever. So in this world, there is no rest for the believer. So we should not wonder about it, we should not seek it, because real restfulness and real happiness and real comfort is not of this world for the believer. قال وَحْذَرْ مَوَاطِنَ الْغَفْلَةِ وَمَخَاتِلَ الْعَدُوِّ وَطَرَبَاتِ الْهَوَى وَضَرَاوَةَ الشَّهْوَةِ وَأَمَانِيَ النَّفْسِ. Full of advice here. And beware of the contexts and the places of heedlessness. Yani where heedlessness, your heedlessness is going to be likely if you are in that context or in that place or in that conversation or in that company. And the ruses and deceits of the enemy and the levities of lusts, and it means also here false doctrine. So levities is or what attracts you, the attractive side of false beliefs, and the rapacity of appetite. And now, so this is the sexual appetite or the gluttony, and the ardent desires of the ego, amani, ardent desire. قال فإن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أعدى أعدائك نفسك التي بين جنبيك. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that your worst enemy is your own soul or your own ego or your own psyche that is between your two flanks, your two sides. And this is well confirmed through different narrations. Although Ibn Rajab considered it a saying of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And anyway, it is a rule of the Sahaba and the Prophet himself, when he said that though the true wrestler is the one who wrestles his own psyche, his own ego, and controls his anger, and many other such hadiths. الذين يجاهدون في سبلنا في يجاهدون في والذين جاهدوا في فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا. Those who are struggling for our sake, we shall certainly guide them to our ways. So they're struggling against themselves because this verse was revealed in the Makki period. That كان قبل جهاد بالسيف. فهمنا؟ إذا هذا جهاد النفس. قال وإنما صارت أعداء أعدائك لطاعتك لها. And the only reason it became your worst enemy, al-Muhasibi said, is because you obeyed it. Allah help us to struggle and disobey our own ego and rather obey Allah. Disobey the whole world and is better than disobeying Allah. And obeying Allah is better than obeying the whole world. والله تعالى أعلم وأحكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم متابع فيما بعد إن شاء الله we'll continue next time. Any questions? وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم الحمد لله رب العالمين. Thank you for joining. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.